First is, much like Azure, we might need access for our CLI or Packer to log in into Azure. Yes or no? In AWS, we have given secret key and access key. Here, we have to give client IDs, subscription ID, and tenant ID. Okay. And then Azure has no IAM, but it has something called as Active Directory. So first you need to have some role. First you need to have some role. We'll be using a role, something called as contributor. Okay. Contributor is a person who can do something. Right, owner is a person who is who can do something as well as he's the owner of it. So he'll also have control on billing. The other one is a guest user or a normal kind of user who can just look at the things. Since we are doing something, we need this contributor kind of role. Right. And after that, once you just generate these details, it is usual business. You have to use a builder, which is an Azure builder. And then you pass the details like how you have passed to the AWS instance builder or AWS EBS builder, right? Amazon EBS builder, you have passed what is your source image and all of that stuff. You almost do the same thing. And then if you want to do any extra activities, you will be doing provisioning. But in provisioning in Azure, there is one more catch. In provisioning in Azure, there is one more catch. In Azure provisioning, you are not supposed to have user information. You are not supposed to have user information. Because remember, yesterday while creating the machine, we had given our own username and our own password in Azure. Right? So whenever you are creating an image, all of your user information, the home directory and the sensitive information of yours should be deleted. Right? For this, you don't need to do anything extra, but there is one extra command or one extra line which you need to execute. One extra line which you need to execute, right? And for removing user information, from your virtual machine is called as generalization. You are generalizing this image so that anyone can use it, right? And this generalization in the, I'm worried about Linux machines. I'm not really worried about Windows images. We have something called as W agent from Azure. This is a Linux agent which is present in every machine, every Linux machine of Azure. We have to take itself. But this is one extra step which we need to do in the case of Azure. In the case of Amazon, you need not, might not have worried about where is that. Yes, in the case of Amazon, you might not never have worried about these kind of things because it's okay in Amazon to have user information, but not in Azure. So provisioning will have one of these steps. And this work is quite the same thing. You have to follow instructions. There is nothing logical over here because the logical thing is we should know what a builder is, which we already know. The logical thing is you should know provisioning. What is the extra script which you want to run? That we already know. If we have to install the LAMP stack, we should know shell provisioning and how do I install LAMP. Or if you are using Ansible provisioning, how do I use Ansible in basically this world? The rest of the stuff is exactly the same, but there are certain extra steps to worry about. First thing is getting those details out, client ID, subscription ID, and tenant ID. And to get that, there is a documentation and you have to follow that blindly. There is no other way out. The logical aim for getting access key and secret key, was there some logic? No, right? There could be a logic where you assign a role. I don't want to give him a contributor role. I want to give him a custom role. That's where your Azure proficiency comes into play. But as of now, for this class, we are okay with default role, which is contributor, right? And then provisioning. So shall we do this? Yeah, okay. Now, for that, the first thing which you are supposed to do is open PowerShell. We have installed Azure CLI already, right? Let me get into some folder where are we doing packer? C drive, DevOps, packer. I'll create a new folder over here. I'll call it as Apache Azure. Right? To install Apache, we know that we have to just do sudo apt-get update and sudo apt-get install Apache. That is our provisioning script, right? But since we are working in Azure, we might need to also use something called as wagent. That is an extra line which always comes up whenever you are working on Azure, right? Okay. Let me open my Visual Studio Code over here. I'll log in into this folder. Okay. And just say AZ login. Once you have installed Azure CLI, you can say AZ login. It will open a page, give your credentials. Good. Okay. Fine. So we have tenant ID over here and we have subscription ID over here already. Right, but we need to get some client ID and all of that. There is no need for you to worry about that. Amazon already has a documentation around it. So, building Packer image Azure CLI. Okay, fine. Now the first step which Azure is trying to tell you is, if you want to do anything in Azure, you need to have a resource group. Yesterday we have looked into it. So the first thing is just create a resource group and give the name to me. Create a resource group and give a name to me. You can go into login into the portal, go into resource groups and then say add a resource group and then do that. Or you can use a CLI itself. I'll go with CLI because it is much easier. I'll copy this, I'll paste it over here. This CLI will create a resource group. Let me call this resource group as Packer. And I want this to be, I prefer Central US. So that's why I'm saying my images will be in Central US. Simple. Resource group is a requirement for anything which you are going to do in Azure. Tomorrow when we work on Terraform also, resource group is where we start our work from, right? So we have a resource group now. Now, let us see the next step. Get Azure credentials. This will work only when you log in. If you don't do AZ login and try to do this activity, you'll not see anything, okay? If you are seeing over here, basically, adding a service principal is creating a contributor role, giving a role-based access to a particular tool, which is Packer, right? The moment you do that, you get these three things, client ID, client secret, and then tenant ID. Not much logical, just copy this, run through. We should get a JSON format. Yeah, did we got this JSON format? Yes. Now what I'll do is I'll copy this JSON and I'll store it in Notepad. Okay, good. Now, you have a client ID. There is only one thing left, which is subscription ID, right? You can go back or find a subscription key, but if you want, you can just copy this query, which will give you the subscription ID. I got a subscription ID. Now let me copy this stuff and go over here and paste it over. I have client ID, I have secret, I have subscription ID, I have tenant ID, and apart from that, I have a resource group which I've called it as Packer. These things are basically required for you to do anything in Azure CL. And to generate this, whether you do it or whether I do it, these are the same steps which you follow, right? Okay, fine. Till this point, it is clear. You are just following the documentation. You are not doing any wonders over here. Okay. Now let me come back. Then he's asking me to create a template, right? Now let me go to the Packer's documentation. Packer. Oh man. Builders. I'm looking at a builder whose type is Azure RM. And if you see, these are the required fields. Client ID is required. Client secret is required. Subscription is required. Image publisher, these are all not required fields, right? So you scroll down and you would tell that there are multiple ways of really creating this stuff, right? We are trying to use the same builder. We are trying to use the same builder. So what I do is, I'd go from the same stuff. I'll copy this and I'll create a builder which I'll call it as apache.json. Okay. Let me remove the unnecessary stuff and we can optimize this by saying that what are the different things that could be variables for you. Client ID, secret key, tenant ID, these should not be written in the file, much like how you write the secret key and access key. So that's why I'll not write it. All of that is fine. So those things will become variables and we know how to put variables, right? So for example, if I don't want to have client ID mentioned over here, what is it I would do? I would just say variables. And then I would write across a variable saying that my client ID. And I'll pass that variable while I'm calling this Packer file. I'm not doing that. But ideally, you should do that because we have discussed about variables. My focus is not on variables now. It is on Azure. You just do this. Do we have client ID? Do we have all of these details now? Right? And the type which we are using is Azure Resource Manager. So let me start with basically putting certain stuffs. Right. Now, what would be going to be your image's name? What is your resource group's name? My resource group name is Packer. We have created a resource group which is called as Packer. Whatever resource group which you want, you can put it over here. What is going to be your image name? I would say my Apache source. Right? And then this is your source. This is your source. In Amazon, you used to give source AMI, where you used to give an AMI ID. Here, you are telling the same thing. OS type is Linux, right? Publisher is something called as Canonical, and we want Ubuntu server, whose version is 16.04. If you want to go with a different version, search for these things in Azure, you will find it out. For example, if you want CentOS-based image, you have to search for these values. Fine? Okay. Tags are okay, right? Fine. Location is Central US, and the machine which is free for us is, for all of us is. Simple. Okay. I still have to pass those four values, client ID, client secret, and all of that stuff. All right. So what is my client ID? Okay. This is my client secret. Tenant ID. Okay. And then the subscription ID. Simple. Now let me come back to the provisioning script. There is no need for that inline execute command and inline shebang. We know that we are executing shell, but that is something which basically they want to give some permissions for this file and all of that. So I'm not changing that, but I'm interested in this stuff, right? So do I need upgrade? I don't think so. What is that I need? I need to install. This is common step across all Azure images. There is no other way. This line has to be there. Remember, we said that we will be using some W agents call. Any Azure image, any Azure Linux image which you are building, that line has to be common. Okay. Without that line, you cannot create an image because you have a user specific information, and Microsoft will never allow you to create an image with a user specific information. The stuff which we are adding extra is this fourth stuff. That's it. Right? I have written the Apache. If you want, you write for Tomcat. If you want, you can write for Node.js. You write for anything over there. But this step has to be there. W agent step has to be there. Right? Because that is how Microsoft works on it. And it is a shell provisioning for your information. There is nothing over here. Even if you don't write this inline shebang and execute command, nothing is going to harm you. Right? You can remove that. In shell provisioning, remember, whenever we have written a shell provisioning, we have written type as shell inline. Right? If you don't like this inline stuff, what you could do is create a file. Create a file. Right? Now let me come back and discuss something over here. Okay. Now what you want to do is you want to create an Apache. You want to create an Apache server. But at the same time, you want to create on both AWS and Azure. How do you do that? You should write a if condition. You should write a if condition saying that if W agent is present, then only execute that command. If W agent is not present, then don't write that command. That is your shell logic. So remember this last line. If you want to make this script work on Amazon, this might not work, right? This is a line where there will be a failure, right? So there what you'll write is, I will execute that line only if W agent is present. And W agent is a Microsoft proprietary tool which is present only in Azure images. So if you go with any AWS image, you'll not see that. So before executing that last line, write a if statement in your shell script. Then you can use the same provisioning for a couple of builders, right? So here you'll be writing, rather than writing one builder, you'll be writing two builders. One is Azure RM, the other one is Amazon's image, right? That's how you go about it. Fine. Now, tags, do I want it? Let it be there. Okay. Fine. So this is a very kind of what you call a manual kind of a process to generate some IDs, and after that it is something which we already know, right? You just pass the details and then you get the image. So shall we see whether this is a valid image, whether it works or not? Yes. So let me go over here and let me first see whether I have written the valid syntax or not. So packer validate apache dot this. Simple. And then packer inspect. Okay. Apache dot JSON. It says that, yeah, you don't have any variables. You are using Azure RM builder and you have a shell provisioning. Yes, that's what I have. Yeah. And then packer build That's okay. I don't want to do debug because there are too many steps in Azure. It will stop at every step. Yeah. So Apache.json. Okay. Now let me tell you what happens. Whenever you do this, Packer will internally create a new resource group. Packer will create a new resource group. In that new resource group, it will create a virtual machine. In that virtual machine, it will do your provisioning. Right? Once everything is being done, then it will create an image. And that image, it will copy into your resource group. Those are the steps. So whenever you do Packer, what happens? A new resource group is created. In that, the virtual machine will be created. Right? And all the things that are required for a virtual machine to work are created. Your provisioning is done. Once the provisioning is completed, then it will create an image and then it will store into your resource group. Am I clear with this? Okay. Now, let me execute this. Sorry. It has too many things and it takes more time. Okay. It is a process which you have to follow. For example, for the people who are trying Windows, there is a Windows PowerShell command based also. I'm not really worried about Windows images. Because in Windows, generally, right, if you want to go with, you will be using PowerShell DSC, and we don't know what a PowerShell DSC is yet for us to execute this. Okay. Okay, since it takes time, let me look at questions now. How to log in into Azure CLI if I'm using it? Same command, it doesn't change, right? Whenever you do it in a Linux machine, what it will give you is, since it cannot open a browser, it will give you a hyperlink. It will ask you to open that in any browser, in any system, then log in, then your stuff will be authenticated. If I want to use AWS image in Azure, is it possible? No. Right? No. It is not possible. But what you can do is, in AWS also use a Ubuntu 16 image. In Azure also use a Ubuntu 16 image and use the similar provisioning. So your result will be the same, but you cannot use the same machine. What if I don't have browser access? Stop using Packer. Because Azure doesn't support any other way, right? There is no other way. Azure, if you have to log in, you need to have some sort of access, right? How you have to authenticate. If you know Azure, I can tell you an alternative way. If you don't know Azure, I'm not speaking about it. Okay. After creating the image VM or instance, will power off or remove instance? It will remove the complete resource group. Once it creates the image, you will no longer be charged because whatever Packer has created, it will delete. The same thing it was doing in Amazon also. If you remember, in Amazon, it was creating a security group. And then it was creating the EC2 instance. Then it was creating a temporary key value pair. It was logging in into that. And once it does all of that, it creates the image successfully, then it will delete all of the stuff which it has created. So there is no need for you to do any sort of cleanup. Packer will do it on its own. Okay. While this is happening, let us see what is happening in Azure. Okay, let me get into resource groups. We have a Packer resource group, but we are seeing some resource group which you have not created. Packer hyphen resource group and some code. This is something which Packer is creating. And now if you get inside that, this is where your virtual machine is being created. If you see what it is trying to create, it is trying to create all the things which are required for your virtual machine. All right. Your virtual machine is also this. This is something which Packer is creating. Now it is executing our provisioning script. This is executing our provisioning script. After it will execute all the commands. Once everything is done successfully, then it will create an image. That image will be copied into or created into our resource group, which is Packer, and then it will remove this resource group. It will remove this resource group so that you are not basically, you will not see a machine in which it has done all of this work. Right? It is no different to Azure when it comes to how it builds, but how it gets into Azure, there are differences. In Amazon, it is quite simple because you can create a secret key and access key, but Azure works in a different way. You need to have something called a service principle because Azure uses REST kind of authentication. So for that, you cannot use something which is static. It is always dynamic. That's it. Okay. And now, while it is doing its stuff, let me look at any other questions. Please explain again client ID, subscription ID, and tenant ID. Those are Azure ways. There is nothing to explain over there. They are basic things which are required in Azure, right? So if you want really want to know about it, just go through how is your how do I say this? Okay, so you might have learned about or you might have came across API services or web API or APIs, right? REST APIs, right? APIs are just services. And how do these services, how can you log in into these services? That's where this tendency is coming to play, right? Client ID is Azure is identifying your CLI as one of its user, right? So there it, you will give a role. So I cannot go beyond that because it is out of the scope of what I discuss, right? You can think of this as username and password for Azure CLI. That's it. I'll not go beyond that. Yeah. We'll cover CA and CD in WinOps as well. No, not really. We'll not cover CA and CD in WinDevOps. We'll be really looking at in CA and CD, whatever we have learned, if I have to include PowerShell or PowerShell DSE, what are the steps? That's what the focus would be. And in the next, we'll start containers, Docker containers, right? And while we learn these 2 weeks of Docker containers, our focus is completely on Linux containers. But in WinDevOps, you'll be learning about Windows containers. So what are Windows containers? How are they built? How can you use Windows servers to create Docker containers? So three activities, PowerShell, PowerShell DSE, and Windows containers. With Jenkins also, you can do CA and CD. If you are expecting me about Visual Studio Team Services, it is not included in our syllabus. Ippatike man chaala ekku undi. Ok, engineering college rendu ellu cheppukochu man syllabus. Right. Let us see what is happening here. It is deleting whatever it has created. And once you go into the Packer, you will see your image. You will see your image. We have to wait. We can't do much.